गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन,
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हाउ वॉज योर न्यू ईयर सेलिब्रेशन एट होम? नो नो सेलिब्रेशन, एंजॉय द हॉलीडेज। ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर टूडे। वी कंप्लीटेड विच चैप्टर वी कंप्लीटेड लास्ट क्लास? एनीबडी रेड? I know Nandana has read because I got some doubts from her. Anna, which chapter we completed? Unmute. I'm not asking any question, only the chapter's name. Unmute first of all. I don't want you to refer.
No, I don't.
Ah, human. Very good. Huh? Human? Human cycle.
Psychology.
Human psychology. Uh-huh. I am teaching you psychology. Malavika?
Body fluids and
circulation. Body fluids and circulation. Anna? You have identified me correctly. No, I am not teaching you psychology. Okay, today we are going to start a new chapter, locomotion and movement. It's not in the order, but why I opted this chapter is we can complete within 2 or maximum 3 periods. So I thought we can reduce the number of chapters to get completed. So this chapter is a very small chapter. As such, the chapter is big, but this year they have deleted majority of the topics from this, and you need to learn only the structure of the skeletal muscle. Structure of the muscle only you need to learn. Please do refer the deleted portions of the revised biology syllabus which I've sent you. And only a small topic you need to learn. But when I'm forwarding the printed notes, I'm not going to delete the topics, as I told you already, because if you need it later, it will be useful. So I'm not deleting, but when you learn for school-based exam, you need to learn only those which are not deleted. The deleted topics you can avoid for school exams, other exams, competitive exams and all. It's your wish. That's why I'm not deleting the printed notes. As such, based on the entire syllabus, I'll be forwarding. But do selections when you are studying for school-based exams. So let us start with the chapter, locomotion and movement. And you know that locomotion or movement from one part of the body, from one place to another, and the movement of different parts. Locomotion means moving from one region to the other region, and your body parts also exhibit different types of movements. All these are brought about by, how is movement taking place? With the help of muscles. Only muscles? Muscles are attached to
bones.
Bones and muscles together bring about movement. And very briefly, you have learned in lower classes. So let us learn more about the structure and the movement of muscles taking place, or movement brought about with the help of muscles. Locomotion and movement. And as I told you, we need to learn only a few topics from this chapter. So the first topic is structure of a skeletal muscle. You have learned about different types of muscles in class 9. Which are the 3 types of muscles, Michael? Which are the 3 types of muscles?
Skeletal
muscles there on the board. Then?
Cardiac muscles.
Cardiac. Okay, we just finished. Then one more is remaining. Huh? Who can help him out? Anybody else? Louder.
Smooth muscles.
So those muscles which are found in your internal organs, which are involuntary. Skeletal muscles are voluntary, which can be controlled according to will. Do you remember any distinguishing feature of skeletal muscle? We have learned a few points. Any distinguishing feature you are remembering? How can you make out skeletal muscle from other muscles. This is having some peculiar pattern. They are striated. What do you mean by striated? What do they have? They have alternate light and dark bands. And as Michael said, you call them as striated or striped muscle because they are provided with characteristic alternate light and dark bands. So let us learn more about the structure of a skeletal muscle. Each skeletal muscle in the body is made of muscle bundles. So as you can see in the figure, the same figure is there in your textbook. So a skeletal muscle you can find there, it is made up of several muscle bundles. So muscle bundles are made up of muscle fibers. So you can see so many muscle bundles or fascicles. Can you see so many muscle, and inside so many muscle fibers or muscle cells are present. So each skeletal muscle is made up of bundles of muscle fibers. You call it as fascicle or muscle bundle. And each fascicle, each muscle bundle is held together by a collagenous connective tissue layer. You call it as fascia. Fascicles are held together by means of fascicles. You can see several such fascicles. So in the figure itself, you can see five of them, five muscle bundles, which consists of muscle fibers or muscle cells. See, muscle fibers, muscle bundles. So each skeletal muscle is made up of fascicles or muscle bundles, which are in turn made up of several muscle. Each one is made up of muscle fibers. And each muscle bundle or fascicles is kept in position. It is held together with the help of a layer. You call it as fascia. Muscle bundle is a collection of many muscle fibers. That is very clear from the figure. So here you can see muscle bundle. So here in the figure, here you can see a muscle bundle, and each muscle bundle you can see so many muscle fibers. Hope you have understood. We are discussing about the structure of a skeletal muscle, and skeletal muscle, each muscle is made up of several bundles of muscles, and each muscle bundle you call it as fascicle. And each muscle bundle is held together. These muscle fibers are kept together in a muscle bundle, and it is kept together or held together with the help of a collagenous connective tissue layer. You call it as fascia. And each muscle bundle is made up of several muscle fibers. Now, if you take a single muscle fiber, so you saw in the figure muscle, once again I'll show it, a muscle bundle, muscle skeletal muscle is made up of several muscle bundles. Each muscle bundle is made up of several muscle fibers or muscle cells. Now we are going to learn about the structure of each muscle fiber or each muscle cell. Muscle fiber has sarcoplasm, similar to cytoplasm. Here you call it a sarcoplasm. It is lined by sarcolemma, similar to plasma membrane. They are having sarcoplasmic reticulum also, similar to endoplasmic reticulum in cell. So the three parts of a muscle fiber: sarcoplasm, similar to cytoplasm, then sarcolemma, sarcoplasm. So each muscle fiber consists of sarcoplasm, a matrix similar to cytoplasm, and it is covered by or lined by sarcolemma. Sarcolemma is similar to plasma membrane. And just like the endoplasmic reticulum, which is a storehouse of energy in a cell. Here we have, in a muscle, we have sarcoplasmic reticulum. They also serve the same function because muscles require energy because they need to work. And sarcoplasmic reticulum is a storehouse for calcium ions. So similar to that, they will help in providing energy. They store calcium ions. The role of calcium ions you will be learning. It is a syncytium. It's a syncytium means it's multinucleated. That already when we learned about the structure of a muscle, skeletal muscle, you have learned it consists of many nuclei. It is multinucleated, whereas cardiac muscle and smooth muscle, they are uninucleated. This one is multinucleated. It is a syncytium, as the sarcoplasm is made up of many nuclei. So scattered in the sarcoplasm, you can find many nuclei. So you call it as a syncytium. A large number of parallelly arranged filaments called myofibrils or myofilaments are present inside the sarcoplasm of muscle fiber. So already we learned that a muscle is made up of muscle bundles. Each muscle bundle is made up of a muscle fiber. Muscle fiber is further made up of several filaments known as myofibrils or myofilaments. So these are present inside the sarcoplasm of a muscle fiber. See here, you can find this is the picture of a muscle fiber. See, this is a muscle fiber. So enlarged view of a muscle fiber, it is having so many myofibrils or myofilaments. That is, so we learned about a muscle. Each muscle has got so many fascicles or muscle bundles. And each muscle bundle is having so many muscle fibers. And each muscle fiber is made up of several myofilaments or myofibrils. Any doubt? Children, any doubt? Okay. So each muscle is made up of several muscle bundles. The other name for muscle bundles is fascicle. Muscle bundles or fascicles. And in each muscle bundle, there'll be so many muscle fibers. If you enlarge and see each muscle fiber, it will be consisting of several parallelly arranged filaments. As you can see in the figure, you call it as myofibrils or myofilaments. Both are same. Now we are going to learn about the structure of a single myofibril. Where do you find myofibril inside? Scattered in the sarcoplasm of? Where do you find myofibril or myofilaments? They are scattered in the sarcoplasm of?
Muscle fiber.
I didn't hear it properly.
Muscle fiber.
To learn about the structure of each myofibril or each myofilament. It's having alternate light and dark bands. See children, here in the figure, you can find fascicles, then muscle fibers, muscle bundles. See the figure. Here you can see muscle bundle, and here so many muscle fibers, enlarged view of muscle fiber. So many muscle fibers. These are different muscle fibers, and a single muscle fiber is enlarged here, and each muscle fiber is having so many myofibrils. This is a single myofibril enlarged. A single myofibril enlarged is shown here. So myofibril is found inside the muscle fiber. Muscle fiber is found in the muscle bundle. Muscle bundle is found in scattered in the muscle. Muscle consists of muscle bundles. Muscle bundle consists of muscle fibers, and muscle fibers is made up of myofilaments. And if you take each muscle fiber, see the enlarged view, you can see dark and light bands in an alternate pattern, alternate light and dark bands. And it is because of these alternate light and dark bands, you call it as striated muscle or striped muscle. Alternate light and dark bands can be found in each myofibril. Now, what makes up the light and dark band, you will see now. Now, light band is made up of the protein actin. So, in 10th standard, I think you've learned about actin and myosin, the muscle proteins which help in the contraction and relaxation of the muscle, bringing about movement. Two types of proteins are there, actin and myosin, two major muscle proteins. And light band contains the protein actin. So light one consists of actin, and the band, the light band, you call it as I band or isotropic band. The first letter I band. Once again, I will repeat, each myofibril is made up of alternate light and dark bands. Light band is made up of a protein known as actin, and this light band, you call it as I band or isotropic band. The protein which makes up isotropic band is actin, whereas the dark band is made up of protein myosin, and you call this band as A band or an isotropic band. This I band and A band are arranged alternately, giving the myofibril a striped or striated appearance. Actin is a thin filament and myosin is the thick filament. Okay, the thick filament is making the band darker. Actin is a thin filament. Actin is thin, so the band is light. Myosin is a thick filament, band is dark. Okay, here you can see actin and myosin, thin and thick filament. Together they constitute, see the green color here in the figure, they have marked green color, that is the darker one, that is made up of myosin, and actin is light in color, and that forms the I band. Once again, I'll repeat, it is important. Each myofibril has got alternate light and dark bands. The light band consists of the protein actin, and the dark band consists of the protein myosin. Myosin is thick and thick, it makes up thick filament, and actin, thin filament. And the band which is formed by the protein actin is known as I band or isotropic band. It is light. Whereas the band formed by myosin is darker. It is known as dark band, A band or an isotropic band. Actin and myosin, they are arranged parallel to each other as rod-like structures, and also to the longitudinal axis of myofibril. So they are arranged parallel to each other. So with respect to each other, that is actin and myosin, they are arranged parallel to each other, and they are also arranged parallel to the longitudinal axis of myofibril. So once again, we'll be summarizing all the points we discussed so far. We started with the structure of a skeletal muscle. Each skeletal muscle is made up of muscle bundles. Each muscle, skeletal muscle, it is made up of muscle bundles. The other name for muscle bundle is fascicles. and each muscle bundle is made up of muscle fibers. And how are these muscle bundle or each muscle bundle is kept together? By means of a collagenous connective tissue layer, you call it as fascia. So muscle bundle consisting of muscle fibers. Muscle fiber, if you take each muscle fiber, it is having a different components: sarcoplasm, sarcolemma, sarcoplasmic reticulum. Sarcolemma is similar to plasma membrane, and sarcoplasm is the cytoplasm, similar to cytoplasm, and sarcoplasmic reticulum is similar to endoplasmic reticulum, and it stores calcium ions. So I'll repeat once again. Each muscle fiber is having sarcoplasm, sarcolemma, and sarcoplasmic reticulum. And I told you these resemble or these are similar to the components present in the cell. So sarcoplasm is similar to cytoplasm, sarcolemma to plasma membrane, and sarcoplasmic reticulum to the endoplasmic reticulum of a cell. And this sarcoplasmic reticulum stores calcium ions. The purpose of the calcium ions we'll be discussing later. And each muscle fiber, it's a syncytium, because the sarcoplasm or scattered in the sarcoplasm, many nuclei are found. And a large number of parallelly arranged filaments. So I told you in the beginning, each muscle is made up of several fascicles or muscle bundles. Each muscle bundle consists of several muscle fibers, and each muscle fiber consists of several parallelly arranged myofibrils or myofilaments. Now next we will see what is the structure of a single myofibril. Each myofibril has got alternate light and dark bands. What makes up this light and dark bands, we'll see. We already discussed it, and it is because of the presence of two types of proteins, actin and myosin, which gives it a characteristic light and dark band appearance. Because of the presence of these bands, you call this structure as a striated muscle, or this muscle as striated muscle or striped muscle. And the light band is made up of protein actin, and you call the band as I band or isotropic band. Whereas the dark band is made up of protein myosin. You should not get confused. Make some tips and tricks to remember these, what makes up light band and what makes up dark band. So LA or DM, somehow you can remember it. Dark band is made up of the protein myosin. You call it as A band or an isotropic band. Light band or I band is made up of actin. Actin is thin and myosin is thick. That is why myosin is giving up a darker band appearance, and actin constitutes the light band. And these are arranged parallel to each other, as well as parallel to the longitudinal axis of myofibrils. Is there any doubt, children? Do you have any doubt? Okay, no, we'll just summarize. And okay, so just summarize the points that we learned. Who will start? Vidur can start.
Each skeletal muscle is made up of fascioles.
Where you're checking? Somewhere you're looking?
No, ma'am.
The textbook is kept on the just in front of you?
No.
You are focusing two sides, here and there. That's why I had a doubt. You're recollecting and saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Each skeletal muscle is made up of several
fascioles.
Fascicles, or what is the simple name? The other name?
Muscle bundles.
Muscle bundles. Okay, Malavika, continue.
Each fascicle is held together by a collagenous connective tissue layer known as fascia.
fascia. Okay, Donna.
A collection of many muscle fibers is known as muscle bundle.
And each muscle bundle consists of several muscle fibers. Okay, Gayatri.
The muscle fibers is lined by sarcolemma, which enclose the sarcoplasm.
Then one more structure we said, it consists of a storehouse of calcium ions.
Sarcoplasmic
reticulum. Then, Naureen.
It is a syncytium as sarcoplasm contains many nuclei.
Yes. Next point, Nandana.
It consists of a large number of parallelly arranged structures known as myofibrils or myofilaments.
Okay. Continue, Evelyn. Now, what do you know about what we have learned about myofibril?
Myofibrils are having alternative light and dark bands.
Okay. Then, Anna?
What makes protein actin and is called the I band?
Or? I band or? Isotropic band. Punya, next point.
The second protein is myosin, which makes the dark band, which is made of an isotropic band or A band.
You're not well?
Yes, ma'am.
New Year special? Cold you have?
Yeah.
Get well soon. Lydia? What is the main difference between actin and myosin?
Actin, thin fibers, and myosin, thick fibers.
How are they arranged, Michael? Michael went to drink water. Michael? Nia?
They are arranged parallel to each other as rod-like structure.
They are arranged. Who are arranged?
Actin and myosin.
Are arranged parallel to each other and also? And also to the longitudinal ridges.
Longitudinal axis of myofibril.
I didn't ask you to complete it. Say the full sentence. Actin and myosin are
parallel to each other and also to the longitudinal axis of myofibril.
Okay. Any doubts? So we'll continue next class. Okay. Thank you, children.